मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ क्लास 11th मैथ्स लेक्चर 3rd ऑफ चैप्टर 16 प्रोबेबिलिटी. क्वेश्चंस ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 16.2. सी क्वेश्चन नंबर फर्स्ट इज अ डाई इज रोल्ड. द इवेंट ई इज डाई शोज 4. सो इवेंट ई विल इंक्लूड 4 ओनली. एंड द इवेंट एफ इज डाई शोज एन इवन नंबर. सो एफ विल इंक्लूड 2, 4 and 6, राइट. Now they have asked if these two events are mutually exclusive or not. Now you can see intersection of these two events includes 4. So the intersection is not equal to 5 and therefore these two are not mutually exclusive, right? Now in question number 2, you have to find unions, intersections and also some other questions related to these events which are given as. The event A is given as a number less than 7. So see, a number less than 7 in the sample space of a die is thrown. So A is equal to S only, right? Because all these numbers are less than 7. The set B is a number greater than 7. So the event B will be 5. The event C is a multiple of 3. So multiple of 3 are 3 and 6. The event D is a number less than 4. So see, the number less than 4 are 1, 2, 3 in the sample space. Now event E is an even number greater than 4. So the greater than 4 and also the even number is 6 only, right? Now F, event F is a number not less than 3. They have said a number not less than 3. That is, the number can either be 3 or greater than 3. But it should not be less than 3. So 1 and 2 will not come, the rest will come. Right? Some students does not consider 3. But you have to be careful. They have said a number not less than 3. So 3 is not less than 3. 3 is equal to 3. So this will also come. Right? Now, what will be A minus C? The elements which are in A but not in C, which are 1, 2, 4 and 5. The next is E intersection F complement, which is E minus F. That is, those elements which are in E but not in F. There is no element which is in E but not in F, because 6 appears in F also. So the answer will be 5. And F complement will be the elements which are in the sample space but not in F. Those elements are 1 and 2. Clear? Question number 3 is, an experiment involves rolling a pair of dice and recording the number that comes up. Describe the following events. The first event A is given as the sum is greater than 8. So see, first of all, the experiment is rolling a pair of dice. Therefore, the sample space will be the ordered pairs x, y, where x and y can be any of these 6 numbers, right? Now, the event A is to find such ordered pairs, the sum of which is greater than 8. So, the sum can be either 9 or 10 or 11 or 12, because the maximum sum you can get is when x is also 6, y is also 6, that is 6 plus 6. 12, right? So with 3, if we take 6, the sum is 9, it is greater than 8. Now with 4, we can take 5 and 6. Now with 5, you can take either 4, 5 or 6, right? Because the sum will be 9, 10 and 11, which is greater than 8. Now with 6, 6, 3, 6, 4, 6, 5 and 6, 6. So these are the ordered pairs so that the sum is greater than 8. Next is 2 occurs on either die. That is, either on first die or on the second die or on both the dies, but 2 should occur. So if suppose 2 occurs at the first die, now at the second die any number can occur. So the cases will be 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5. 2, 6. Now we will consider the case when 2 occurs at the second die. Now the cases will be 1, 2, 2, 2. We have already considered. So 3 2, 4 2, 5 2 and 6 2. Clear? Now the next event C is the sum is at least 7 and a multiple of 3. So at least 7 means either the sum is 7 or greater than 7, and you know it can go up to 12 only, right? Now they have also said that the sum should be at least 7 and a multiple of 3. So multiple of 3 out of these numbers are only 9 and 12. That is, we will find such ordered pairs the sum of which is 9 and 12. So with 3 it will be 6, then 4 5, 5 4, 6 3 and 6 6, because the sum of this will be 12, right? So these are the ordered pairs the sum of which are greater than or equal to 7, and the sum is also the multiple of 3, right? Now see, they have asked to check which of these events are mutually exclusive. So you will find that intersection of these two is 5, therefore A and B are mutually exclusive, and also intersection of B and C is 5, therefore B and C are also mutually exclusive. A and C are not mutually exclusive because this ordered pair 3, 6 exists in C also and in A also, right? Now the next type of events are exhaustive events. See, if E1, E2 up to EN are N events of a sample space S, such that union of these events is equal to the sample space, then we say all these events are exhaustive events, right? If some of the events of the sample space S, if we take union of those events and if it is equal to the sample space, then such events are known as exhaustive events. For example, see this case. In experiment of rolling a die, one event is 2 appears. So event A will be 2. Event B is even number appears. So the event B will be 2, 4, 6. Event C is number not less than 3. That is either 3 or greater than 3. So this will be 3, 4, 5, 6. And number D is 1 appears. So D will contain the number 1. Right? Now take the union of these. Union of all these 4 events will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Which is nothing but the sample space of rolling a die. Therefore, because the union of these are equal to the sample space, we will say these events A, B, C and D are exhaustive events. See one more example. The event A is even number appears. So A will include 2, 4, 6. And event B is odd number appears. So event B will be 1, 3, 5. Now in this case, you can see that union of these two is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That is the sample space. That is why we can say that these two events are exhaustive events, because union of these two is equal to the sample space. But also at the same time, you can see that the intersection of A and B is 5. That is, they are mutually exclusive also. So such events which are mutually exclusive and also exhaustive are known as mutually exclusive and exhaustive events, right? Those events which are mutually exclusive and exhaustive are known as mutually exclusive and exhaustive events. Clear? So if E1, E2, EN are N events of a sample space S, such that union of all of these events is equal to S, that is, they are exhaustive. And also, if we take any two of these events, then their intersection is 5, then that is, they are mutually exclusive also. So such events are known as mutually exclusive and exhaustive events, right? This is another type of event, mutually exclusive and exhaustive events, which are those events which are mutually exclusive also and exhaustive also, right? Exhaustive means that union of these should be equal to S, and mutually exclusive means if you will take any of the two events, their intersection should be phi, which can be written as EI intersection EJ is equal to phi, where IJ belongs to the set 1 to N. That is, these events are nothing but these events only, but I should not be equal to J, right? Because EI intersection EI will be EI only. So the intersection of any two different events will be phi. Then they will be called as mutually exclusive events, right? Now see this example to understand it. So the experiment is tossing three coins. The event A is at least two head appears. So at least means either two heads or all the head occurs, right? The event B is all tails, and the event C is one head appears. So one head appears. So it will include these cases, right? Now you can see union of these three events, A union B union C, is equal to the sample space of tossing three coins. Also, if we take the intersection of any two events, A intersection B, A intersection C, and B intersection C, so you can check that there is nothing common between them. Therefore, intersection of all these three will be phi. That is why we can say that the three events A, B and C are mutually exclusive and exhaustive events. Clear? So your homework is do question number 5th and 7th of exercise 16.2 and read all the examples up to exercise 16.2. Okay, thank you.